This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. This is Openly Hostile Opinions.
Hello everyone.
As always, I'm Jay. This here is Casey.
Hello everyone. How's everyone doing today?
Considering I'm the only other person in the room, I'm doing fucking excellent.
Yeah, me too. Except today I've had sort of a bad day. My heat went out. It's been out for, three, 4 days, something like that. It's a little chilly in here.
Just like your heart.
Yes, exactly. So, and then to make things worse, my dryer stopped working, so I'm sort of wearing damp clothes. Right?
So you have no heat and you're wearing damp clothes.
Yes, but I'm damp for you, so it's okay.
Hey!
And speaking of damp, we're going to be talking about, you know, eating pussy later, so the day should get better. And
who the hell would do that?
Yeah, I know. It's actually pretty funny. I was getting a shower earlier, and there's this cold draft going through the house. And I'm sitting there, I'm standing there trying to take a shower, and the air is blowing the curtain towards me. So I'm trying to, like, wash my hair, the curtain's, like, sticking to my face, and I'm like, oh, man, this is horrible.
Is this coming through, like, a window, or?
No, it's just without the heat running, there's this draft coming, and I don't know where it's coming from. It's just blowing my curtain at my face.
Oh, my God. You just got, like, holes in your walls and shit?
Yeah, probably. What? I don't know. This house, oh man, it's nice living, you know, in the middle of nowhere, and I have really no neighbors or anything, but it's just a pain in the boot.
What are you, Canadian now?
Yeah, what are you talking about? But yeah, other than that, things should turn out better. We got some beer in front of us, and it is Goose Island. I've always seen previews for this all over the place. It's even on YouTube every once in a while when I watch a video, and I've always wanted to try it. It's Goose Oktoberfest. I know it's not October anymore, but fuck it. And it says dried apricot and toffee aroma, whatever the fuck that means. It sounds like something from Starbucks.
A mocha choca bullshit.
Yeah, mocha choca. Let's try this beer here.
Ooh. I don't know if I like that one very much.
Yeah, it has a really strong aftertaste for an Oktoberfest, I'd say.
It's almost pilsnery. It's very effervescent, very sharp tasting.
Yeah, like I know Budweiser owns it. Well, supposedly, I heard that. I don't know.
Bush.
Yeah, they're from, originally from Chicago. I don't know if they still are. Yeah, it does. It does sort of taste like something Budweiser would make, to tell you the truth.
It does. It tastes like slightly more exciting Budweiser.
Yeah, and I'd say it's pretty strong taste for an Oktoberfest. I like Oktoberfest because I think they're pretty smooth, but this one is, I don't know, sort of rough around the edges.
Like I said, it's just like drinking that yellow fizzy piss water.
Yeah, yeah.
With a slight tinge, maybe a half a hop thrown in there for flavor.
Yeah, I like the other beers that we tried recently better. I would, if I would rate this, I'd probably give it 3 Catholic priest kid touchers out of 5.
I'm gonna go with two Catholic priest kid touchers. I'm not really excited by this one at all.
Yeah, it's the taste is. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to comb the taste out of my mouth later.
It's not bad. It's just very very boring.
Yeah, it's a mass produced beer, so you know you're not gonna probably get something, you know, too much. But whatever.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to try it.
Can't win them all.
It's okay. It's okay.
By the way, for those of you who have been asking, no, we do not have a beer sponsorship. But if any beer companies out there feel like sponsoring...
Yes. That would be awesome.
That would be great.
Before we get into things, though, today, we actually got our first patron.
Yes, we did. Thank you, Shane Hartle. We appreciate it. He pledged $1 a show. Even every little dollar helps. If you want to end up back there, it's going to cost you $5 a show. Yeah. But hey, come on. You spend more than that at fucking Starbucks on your extra grande mocha choca bullshit.
And that $5 foot long at Subway. So, yeah. Thank you, Shane. You're our first patron. That's awesome.
Thanks, buddy.
We can't thank you enough. You're awesome. Thank you very much. Ooh, excuse me.
Shane Hartle, you're the man.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, what do you got for us today?
Well, like I said, we're going to be talking about vagina. So today's first article is eating vagina can cure cancer.
Well, then.
It was a conducted at State University of New York. I didn't even know that was a fucking college.
Apparently so.
It's probably a college under like a subway where all the homeless people live or something. But basically, they came to find that it produces a hormone called DHEA that kills cancer cells.
Okay, if that's all it takes is DHEA, you can buy that shit on the shelf at the grocery store.
Yes.
I mean, you know, eating pussy's all right, too.
Wait,
you've
heard of DHEA before? I've never heard of it.
Yeah, it's a supplement. You can buy it at the grocery store.
But I think this is funner. Wait, I just used a word that doesn't even exist. Funner.
Funner.
Sorry, I got pussy on my mind. I can't think straight right now.
Our only fucking job is to talk. And
I just used the word funner.
Funner.
But also some headlines here about
it. Is that most good?
Yeah, it's most good. Yes.
Is that gooder?
Gooder. They say that it also helps with heart disease, migraines, and something for the men here. They say beating off does basically the same thing for men. So when you drain your, you know, natural septic tank down there.
So my options are either getting my tongue all stretched out and getting that little cramp under your tongue. You know what we're talking about there, fellas.
Yeah.
or I can just whack off. Dude, if whacking off saved the world, no men would ever die. This is bullshit.
But it's like they could be, you know, doing other things, but they're doing a study on eating vagina cures cancer.
I'm pretty sure there's some scientists out there just trying to make a buck.
Yeah, I know.
Or just to justify.
Yeah, they're like, let's go the Howard Stern route and just, you know, make everything disgusting. But there was some user comments, and the guy was using, whoever wrote this, was using the word girl, and someone got pissed. Of course they did. And wrote, a girl's opposed to a woman's? You sick fuck.
2016.
Yeah. I got another story about people getting offended. It's just crazy today. But
you know, being offended, my favorite thing to say about that is being offended is just another way of saying that I can't control my own emotions, so I expect you to do it for me.
Yep.
Grow up and stop being a bitch.
Exactly. I'm just going to... Man, what was that on the one show where that guy dressed like a clown and he put baby powder on his hands?
Oh, Homie the Clown.
Yeah, homie don't play that and just smack people with... Bacon,
yeah, that was on In Living Color.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, yeah. Oh God,
where Jim Carrey first got his start, actually.
Yeah. God, I loved him.
We're showing our age right
now.
Yeah,
we're showing our age. But yeah, that's pretty much it. And I'm wondering, since this is out, do you think guys are gonna be using this as a pickup line?
Hey, bitch, come on back to my place. We'll cure some cancer.
Yo, Baldy, the one that looks like Mills Lane.
I'll allow it. Yeah.
He'll be hitting on her. He'll be like, you want to go home? And she'll be like, I'll allow it.
Oh, man.
We're starting to show off right. We probably just offended everyone because we're making fun of cancer patients.
Whatever.
I know. You know, if I'm going to use it. if I'm at a bar and I see a bitch with cancer, I'm like, yo, bitch. I got scientists behind me. You can't argue with that.
Oh, yeah. What are they going to think of next?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know. Sex robots? Speaking of sex robots, remember how we talked about that last week?
Oh, that's right. I forgot to look up that girl and see if she was hot or not.
She's not.
Oh, really?
Damn. She's not huge or anything, but she's certainly not not what I'd call real super attractive. She kind of got like the... just kind of got that like short pixie haircut thing. Oh, why do women do that?
I don't know, man. I just want a fucking pixie slap the shit out of them when they do that.
I don't give a fuck who you are. Nobody looks good with a pixie.
I know. Hair. Jennifer Lawrence did it. I was like, I'd still fuck her.
Yeah, but still.
Because I want to see her butthole because I want to know how it makes me not feel comfortable.
Oh, she looks so cute. Oh, Rihanna. Look at Rihanna. Rihanna looks so cute. No, they don't. They all look like hell.
Yeah, Rihanna only looks good with black eyes, but whatever.
Fucking Halle Berry. Yeah, sorry. I don't know. Whatever.
Nah.
Anyway, sex robots with fully functional genitalia are set to arrive next year, and they are going to cost 12,000 euros.
Holy fuck, man. I don't actually... Having a girlfriend or being married, that's pretty cheap.
These are like the Cadillacs of fuckable robots, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Do they have, like, warmers?
Yes, actually. They have built-in heaters to have genuine body warmth and sensors that can react to the touch.
That's fucking great. That's so great.
It's Real Doll is going to make these ones. This has nothing to do with that sex robot expo for Christmas sex robot expo.
Oh, this is completely
expo.
Different.
Okay. Yeah, this is just Real Doll being creepier than ever. They have, their founder, Matt McMullen, said, and I quote here, "I want to have people actually develop an emotional attachment to not only to the robot, to the actual character behind it, to develop some kind of love for this being."
Can they give the robot cancer so he eat their pussy? Where's the button for that?
I'm pretty sure there'll be a button to, you know, just spread your legs regardless what the
but there's a picture of the robot mannequins in the back and they have no hair. They have cancer already.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
But, I mean, they want to have the AI be able to be good enough to tell what's going on, although mm-hmm. I'm sure they're not going to give her options or free will.
That's true. Like, what if she's not in the mood? I hope they don't make robots.
I'm pretty sure they're not going to have a not-in-the-mood robot setting.
They can't, dude. If they do that, I'd be so pissed. I'd get it all out of the wrapper or whatever the fuck it comes in, spent 12 grand on it. And then all of a sudden, it's like, I am not in the mood.
I love the fact that you're speaking about this as if you are absolutely going to get one. There's no question.
Oh, I'm going to play the lottery constantly now so I can win one. I hate people. I don't want to deal with it. Hey, this completely cuts out that, hey, where do you want to eat at conversation.
Oh, my God. How terrible. Where do you want to eat? That's the epitome of your life?
Yeah, basically. There's actually, it's not just me. There's actually a restaurant.
Yeah.
It's called I Don't Care. So when your wife asks, I don't care, you take her to I Don't Care. I don't know if it's just one restaurant or if it's a chain. Yeah. Whoever.
That's brilliant.
Yeah, that's amazing. I don't, like I said, I don't know if it's a chain or whatever, but yeah, that's crazy. But
I don't know. I've never had that much trouble trying to figure out where the fuck to eat.
I know. I'm always like, bitch, we going here.
And you wonder why you're single.
Yeah, I know. I'm single because I'm waiting for the sex robots.
That's probably the only woman who will be willing to sleep with you at this point. Who's not, like, you know, stalking you and making macaroni art and leaving it on your porch.
Yeah. Oh, man.
God. You certainly know how to pick them, Case.
Yeah, I know. She just got a hold of me the other day, and I, like, got this feel of dread and doubt over me when I saw it was her. I'm like, oh, God, because I think she was in jail. So I'm like, oh, God.
What was she in jail for?
Heroin or something. I don't know.
Oh, good.
Yeah, I know. Why don't you love me? I don't know. I couldn't tell you.
Jesus Christ.
I know. You...
Come on. Yeah, but you're crazy. Let's go.
That's what I'm saying. Now, me wanting a sex robot, it still looks pathetic, but it's starting to look a lot better, I think.
Oh, God, Casey.
I know. Oh, man. Just got to laugh it off. Laugh it off.
Well, you know what? I can kind of see your point because I saw another story this week. this fucking scum-sucking scumbag gets her 20 boyfriends to buy her 20 iPhone 7s, sold them all to buy a house.
Ugh. I wish I could fucking do that. Jesus.
She's a Chinese blogger by the name of Proud Kioba. And she was in her... She has all these boyfriends online. She tried to get it. She got these guys to buy her 20 fucking iPhone 7s.
Holy fuck. See, I wish I could do that, man. Like, but I can't because I'm a man. Like...
You know, here's the thing, though. When you stop and think about it, what's an iPhone 7 cost?
I have no idea. I hate bucks, Apple maybe? Products. Fuck you, Apple.
All right. Well, let's say, for instance, it's they're roughly, what, $600? We'll say $600.
I have no clue. There's different gigs. There's all sorts of shit.
I'm going for roundabout here. So let's look here. $600 times 20. That's only $12,000.
Yeah. What house did she buy?
It's
Barbie's
China.
Barbie's dream house?
I don't know.
Well, the Barbie's dream house is probably made in China.
Probably.
Yeah.
But, you know, $12,000 don't get you. I mean, it's a nice down payment, I suppose, if you're living in a cheap area.
Yeah, I have no clue how Chinese people live. I know they kill each other more than us over here, but whatever.
Goodbye, Chinese viewers.
They don't know what we're saying anyway, so we're okay.
My God.
I know. So did these men retaliate at all when they found out she did this, or did they love her so much that they don't really care?
It doesn't say.
Oh, man.
Oh, okay. I guess she got $885 each for him, I guess.
Holy fuck.
Okay, so now that we have a real figure here. Hit the microphone.
Whoopsie.
All right, so let's see here. Do you need a mint?
Maybe. Eating all that pussy to cure cancer.
All right, so that gives us $17,000, $700.
Okay. So she has a little bit more to work with.
Still, how the hell are you buying a house for $17,000? Where do you buy that at?
I know, and here's the thing.
You can't even buy a good car for that.
You know, all these women and shit, they want equal rights. I can't do that. You have equal rights if you could fucking do that. I wish I could lean on 20 fucking guys, get them to buy me iPhones, and then fucking buy a house with them. I know it's off topic, but I get into these woman rants.
Well, that's because you're terrible.
I know.
I mean, there are terrible human beings out here. Look at how many fucking shitty guys are out there. How many guys do you hear about that knock up some chick and then poof, they're gone. The magic has happened. They are nowhere to be found. They're faking their deaths and shit.
They're like, oh, she found me on Facebook.
She's calling. They're getting his mom to tell him he died.
Yeah.
He died whitewater rafting.
Yeah, that's like that episode of Family Guy where he calls off work and he's like, "Mr. Weed, I died in a horrible plane crash and I'm a vegetable. See you tomorrow."
I mean, some of these women are just fucking terrible, but you know, like I said, there's just as many crazy guys.
Yeah,
but on the same vein of people, women who have way too much fucking control over weak-minded fools.
Oh, God.
There's this other chick I read about this week called Poison Ivy. She's a 17-year-old chick from New Zealand who has ample titties, I guess. And
is there a picture of him? I want to see his titties.
She's 17.
Yeah, whatever. I'm just joking. But... She's not even that pretty. Like, she looks cross-eyed.
She's Asian.
What?
She's Asian.
I guess the second picture there, she looks a little Asian. What? Oh, she has Stuart written on her forehead. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. It's for some dude, but the other guys, they write her name. Her name's Hannah. They write their name.
Mm-hmm.
They write her name in indelible marker on their foreheads, and she got one of them to shave his hair and shave his eyebrows off, and then made fun of him for it. And
wait, what did that say up there? She said why she treats the men like this or something. What did that say? Go up a little bit. Yeah, right there.
I treat all men. She says I treat all men like shit because they're weak and deserve it. I bully the weak to make them weaker as I simultaneously grow stronger.
What, are you a super villain? Our name is Poison Ivy. That's too good for a 17-year-old to write. I think she ripped that out of a Batman comic.
She's 17. She probably did rip it out of a Batman comic.
Don't you think that sounds like something like in a Batman comic that Poison Ivy would say?
Poison Ivy is more class than this bitch.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, and see, this is another thing. Like, if a guy did this, he'd be in fucking jail right now.
Oh, my God, yeah. And she encourages dudes to send her, like, dick pics. And
probably post them and stuff like that.
Right, and then spreading their butt cheeks and on camera and stick shit up their ass. And
And she's only 17?
Right, and then she blackmails them.
Oh, my God. She's only 17, and she is that much of a heartless twat.
Yeah, exactly. She's a horrible human being. If you want to go and give this woman a little hate, her Twitter handle is at Poison Ivy Lull, L-U-L.
We're not, you know, suggesting hate. We wouldn't do that on this show, but it's Poison Ivy, L-U-L.
Well, you know, she's obviously a piece of shit, but she's 17, so hopefully she learned some shit.
Now, you said she was Asian. Is she from, like, one of the Asian countries, or is she American?
She's from New Zealand.
Oh, that makes sense, because Australian women are just like American women, just cold, heartless, fucking brutal pieces of shit. not all, but this sounds...
Generalizing a little bit, are you?
No, but this sounds like something an American woman would do, don't you think? Just bored.
No, what it sounds like is an immature 17-year-old cunt with delusions of grandeur, and then the internet gave rise to a bunch of socially awkward misfits who can actually communicate with one another now rather than learning how to deal with social interaction. Everybody just sticks on the internet now and falls madly in love with some bitch thousands of miles away from him who is manipulating him into doing dumb shit and...
Well, see, the funny thing is I know women like this, and once a guy treats her like garbage, she is going to throw his dick right in her mouth. That's how this works. She's entitled. So I saw a video the other day my one friend sent me. This guy was emptying trash, and this girl drove by in a car, and he looked and waved, hello. She fucking flipped balls, got her video camera out, started recording them. And was like, I'm going to get you for rape and sexual harassment. And he's standing there with his hands open. He just drops the trash and he's like, all I said was hello. Like, what the fuck's going on? She's like, you don't say hello to someone you don't know. And I'm like, what is going on in this video? The amount of entitlement that all people have.
I said hello, not suck my dick.
Yeah, exactly. Holy shit, man. But
that's a huge bitch.
And that's the thing, like. This bitch got out of her car to scream at this guy for saying hello, and it's like, you wonder why people don't get along anymore. You don't want people to get along with you. You can't even say hello to people.
To be fair, I don't really want anybody to say hello to me. Fuck everybody.
Yeah, and you say I'm a miserable fuck.
I'm just a loner. There's a difference.
Yeah. Well, I am too.
Well, here, listen to some of this shit she tweeted.
There's tweets. This is good. I need some popcorn. This is great.
Romance is very stupid, and everyone always breaks up in the end. Or it ends in some way or another. The only way to do it properly is for a couple to suicide together, because that way they will have been together forever, as they surely promised each other. Yeah, that's not a bleak outlook in life.
Is this girl related to me? Sounds like something I'd say. It all ends in death.
So she says, so my dream is to find a male version of myself, precisely like me, but a male, to live hedonistically with in a neat hovel. And we just do drugs, have lots of sex, and then suicide together.
Oh, my God.
Suicide is apparently a verb now.
Oh, jeez. Well, we made Nancy Grace a verb, so I guess this girl has the right to.
Yo, I'm going to go home and suicide.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. I just suicided that burp. Holy shit.
Feel bad for anybody who's listening to us some days.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. No, I'm not. But anyways, what the fuck is that? Oh, is that more?
Oh, yeah, that's this jackass, like...
That one guy
posted a picture of himself pulling his underwear up in his ass, and this guy carved Hannah into his fucking chest.
Does it say anything why she has such a bad outlook? Something must have happened.
She's a cunt. What more do you need?
But dude, this is dark shit, man. This is like, this girl's only 17. She's feeling this way. It took me like 30 years to feel this way.
Yeah, most teenagers go through their little awkward.
I know, I did, and it was me. Phase, it was me, like, taking pictures with my middle finger up, like, ooh, I'm badass. You know, you remember doing that? You're like, I'm such a rebel. Fuck the government. Yeah. Fuck
everyone. Yeah, it's like bitches now with the duck face.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Man.
Everybody put their middle finger out. Yeah. Look at me. Nowadays, it's people holding pistols.
Oh, yeah. There was a... Back to Instagram, there was this guy. He was taking a picture with his pistol. He was acting like he's all tough. And it was a revolver, and he took like a 30 round clip, and he ended up like he was holding it like it was an extra long clip, and he was dead serious. Like it was a six shooter, and he's holding a 30 round clip like it's a part of, and the internet just ripped into it.
Watch out, we got a badass over here.
People were holding up vacuum cleaners with clips and banana clips on them and shit, just making fun of them. It was great. Oh, man. I can't believe, though, that someone like that has a voice to make people do stuff like that. Like, I'm sort of jealous because I wish I would have thought of it. That's like, I thought I was like the coldest, heartless, most piece of shit in the world, but I guess not. Holy fuck.
Hey, why not? Yeah. Let's go suicide together.
Yeah, let's suicide it. Fucking shit, man. I actually, like the Japanese used underwear vending machines, I want to look more into that because I guarantee something happened to her. I guarantee some man ripped her fucking heart out and she's going to fucking, you know.
She's 17. Everything, when you're 17, everything is the end of the world.
Yeah.
You know, everything is the most devastating thing on the fucking face of the planet.
Man, she's a white girl, so it's probably something like they spelled her
name
wrong.
She's Asian.
Whatever.
What, are we going to say, oh, that's close enough?
Yeah, that's close enough.
Jesus Christ, Donald Trump, settle down over there.
I'm not a billionaire or whatever like he is.
Yeah, at least if you're a billionaire, you could get away with saying that.
Is he a billionaire or is he a millionaire?
I don't know.
Yeah.
He won't release his tax returns.
That's right. I forgot about that.
Who gives a shit?
Yeah, he probably has them hidden under his hair.
Who cares? Who fucking cares? Well, you know what? I am getting so disgusted with both sides of this fucking election.
I know,
at this
man.
Point.
It's getting old. It's
I
getting
cannot
old
fucking
quick.
Wait. We got like 1 week to go yet. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like, oh, email this, email that. Oh, grab her by the pussy. Yep. Well, here's what the deal is. Hillary Clinton is a fucking crook in Congress. What do you expect?
Yeah,
she's a goddamn congressperson.
Yep. Yep.
She's a senator.
Yep.
They're all crooked.
I know.
It don't matter which one you pick. They have crooked bullshit.
I know. It's basically what position do you want to get fucked? Basically.
Yeah.
Like, what's it's ridiculous.
You know, and it's not even... And then you got Donald Trump, who's a notable piece of shit. He was a notable piece of shit before he ran for office.
Yeah.
But he had enough money to be a piece of shit and get away with it.
Yeah, he's a businessman. Businessmen are dirty because to be successful, you have to be a dirty piece of shit.
You know, everybody's saying shit about the emails Hillary destroyed. Of course she did. She's a fucking politician.
Yeah.
Of course she did.
I know.
And then you've got Trump, who fucking deleted a bunch of emails and shit, too, during lawsuits and shit, because who cares? The fine costs less than what he's going to lose in the lawsuit, so who gives a shit?
I know, and you can do whatever the fuck you want when you have that much money. You can even, like, pay off the FBI and stuff.
But
like, who fucking cares?
You know, it's not even the politics. It's not even the two jackasses running right now that bother me so much.
It's the people.
It's their fucking people that are supporting them.
I know, man. I can't take it
anymore.
Like,
these fucking jackasses who are supporting Trump out there, they're the most xenophobic, racist idiots I've ever heard in my life. There's some out there who have legitimate reason for supporting him, although I haven't met one yet. Some people out there would say that they want to have somebody who's not a career politician. I used to think that way, too. But I've changed my mind, and I'll tell you why.
Mm-hmm.
The reason I think it's good to have somebody with experience in there is because, first off, we had Barack Obama for the last 8 years who had no real experience. Very immature, very young senator. Or was he in... either way. He was a congressperson. He had only been in Congress for a few years. He had no experience, and he did a shitty job for the last 8 years. He did nothing in 8 years because he didn't have the experience to know how to wheel and deal and get shit done.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's like saying, oh, I don't want a politician. I don't want a corrupt politician. Okay, so let's put a corrupt businessman in there. There's a great idea.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the deal. It's like hiring some kid off the street who's never held a paintbrush in his life to paint your house because you wanted a new perspective.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't work. You need to get somebody who knows what the fuck they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Even if that person is a corrupted piece of shit, because guess what? Every one of them is.
I know. That's ridiculous.
Every single one of those 100 senators, you cherry pick any one of them, they all suck.
I know. They vote on their own raises. Like, can you imagine going to work and you're like, I feel like having a raise today. Vote. Who's going to say no?
Yeah.
I don't want more money.
Yeah.
Money? That's evil.
These people are so far removed from anything that normal people have to deal with. They have their own DMV in Congress.
Yep.
They have their own haircutting place in Congress. Now, technically, that DMV is open to the public. Good luck finding it.
Yeah, exactly. It's so, I cannot wait till this fucking shit is over because it's making me sad for the human race. And why is...
Everybody's fighting. Everybody's arguing. Everybody's like, oh my God, if Hillary Clinton gets in office, I'm going to go fucking kill myself. If Donald Trump's in office, I'm moving to fucking Switzerland.
I know, I'm moving to Canada.
Shut the fuck up.
I know, like, go fucking somewhere where, like, in Ethiopia where they can't even fucking eat. Like, fuck off. Like, everyone thinks they have it so fucking bad here. And it's just like, shut the fuck up.
Like, for those of you out there who are worried about Donald Trump getting in office, I'm a little bit concerned about him having the fucking control of the nukes. But other than that, you know, like, he's not going to be able to accomplish shit. Congress is going to hamstring him and basically make him sit in the corner like a bad kid sitting on his hands.
I know. And that's the thing.
And Hillary Clinton's not going to be able to do shit because unless the Democrats get a controlling seats in Congress, they can't do shit either.
I know, and that's the whole point.
So
and I
deal
know
with it.
People were pissed how many years ago where Congress just was at a dead standstill because they couldn't agree on shit.
Well, nobody works together anymore.
I know, but here's the thing. That's good. That's what's supposed to happen. When you have a president trying to do executive orders and do this and do this,
well, no,
Congress is supposed to step in. And
yeah, but Congress needs to learn to compromise. That's the problem.
I know, and that's the thing. But sometimes compromise isn't good. There needs to be times where it's like, you know what? You're out of control. You know,
right.
Let's just stop.
But that's the thing. That's they both need to learn to meet in the middle, and they're not doing that
anymore.
I know,
and that's the thing. I'd like to see it, but I don't. It's bad and it's good. But it's good for them to be fighting because that's the whole point. The whole point is to, you know, be like, hey, this isn't right. Well, why isn't this right? Well, you get the floor for this amount of time. So, you know, you get to
say. There's never going to be civility.
I know.
But, I mean, you know, the way it's supposed to work anyway is that, you know, Democrats come with this crazy liberal idea and say, healthcare is broken. We want to give everybody free healthcare and no compromises. And then the Republicans are supposed to say, hey, we support the fact that, you know, healthcare is broken. We agree.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try to find some common ground. And they're supposed to work together to try to find that common ground that works for everybody, both conservative and liberals. But what's not happening anymore, nobody's willing to work together.
Yeah, and that's the thing. They really don't work. You know why? Because they do some slimy fucking shit.
Well, of course they do.
Like,
they're
do you remember when Obamacare came out? The first written form of it was 9 times longer than the Bible.
Yeah.
And you know what the Democrats or whoever, I don't know who wrote it or whatever. Like I said, I tried to stay out.
Well, it was bipartisan, but
yeah.
It was poorly bipartisan.
Well, they were saying, well, if it's long enough, people won't read the whole thing. And I'm just like, see, that's why you don't work together, because you're fucking slimy.
I mean, the Democrat plan was to have a single-payer system, basically Medicare for everybody.
Yeah.
And the plan that we have in place right now is largely similar to what was proposed by House Republicans under the Bush administration.
Mm-hmm.
However, none of those Republicans now will admit to that shit because they want to be able to blame it on Obama.
Yeah.
But, I mean, the fact of the matter is the healthcare situation the way it is totally fucked.
Yeah, of course it is.
The Affordable Care Act made nothing affordable.
Exactly.
And, you know, there's still tons of Americans without health care. It didn't work. We need to start over, scrap it, and do something different.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's never going to come to a decent compromise unless everybody learns to fucking work together.
Mm-hmm.
Which, the way things are going right now, I don't know what to blame it on the internet or what, that everybody's getting into these fucking echo chambers and getting so extreme in each side that nobody's willing to compromise.
And like I said, I was talking to you earlier today about, I just think people are fucking bored.
They are. They
I
do
know.
Dumb shit.
They're
because
just
they have
looking
nothing
up,
better to do.
Yeah, they're fucking getting guys to give themselves wedgies and shove shit up their ass. There's people, you know, bored, and they're just ranting online about how shit upsets them, and oh man, I can't take it, Jay. But actually, it is pretty civilized compared to, I was watching videos, I guess Ukraine has a crazy, like, Congress or something, I don't know, there is fist fights every fucking day. Like, chairs thrown.
You know what, I'd almost rather that than this, you know, back channel communique.
Yeah, Hunger Games
deals.
Remember what I told you the other day? Hunger Games. You want a president?
You're a horrible person.
Oh, I don't fucking care. You want a presidential candidate? Instead of pay with your money, pay with your fucking life.
What? You know, I learned some shit the other day about the whole electoral college process. Mm-hmm. I think the whole thing needs to be done away with because the Electoral College at this point is bullshit.
It is.
Just due to the fact that nowadays we do have the technology and we do have the communication to be able
to do the popular vote. Yeah, exactly. And we should be getting to that, but
right.
It's a way to, you know, mass stuff. We know how the Electoral College works. It's really not that good of a system, but back in the day, it was.
It was necessary.
Yeah, because you couldn't really, you know...
Right.
You know, keep track of shit, but now we can.
Right.
And you know, we're coming out with sex robots, so we can at least, you know, get a good ballot system.
Right. And it'd be nice to do away with the Electoral College, but, you know, I was learning some shit about it, and originally the first idea before we had the people pick the president was to have Congress do it, mm-hmm. to elect somebody, but they decided not to do that, and I'll tell you why that was a good idea to not do that, even though Congress probably could elect somebody moderate, because yeah. you've got the Democrats and the House Republicans sitting there trying to come up with somebody who nobody hates entirely. And the reason that didn't work is because they figured what would happen is there'd be Congress people who were interested in the job constantly campaigning for it, mm-hmm. amongst Congress rather than trying to get anything accomplished.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's good that people do it, although the other reason that they were kind of, the Founding Fathers were scared of having the people be in charge is because largely at the time, most people were ignorant and weren't able to understand the issues, and there wasn't the kind of communication that there is today.
Mm-hmm.
So people didn't have any clue who the hell these people were that were being nominated.
Mm-hmm. You basically had to know them, sort of, or be in the same town as them.
Right, and if they didn't come from your home state, you wouldn't even know who the hell they are.
Yeah, can you imagine politicking back then? Holy fuck, that would be so hard. Like, nowadays, you can spend money, you can be on TV. Back then, you had to get on a soapbox, basically.
Well, nowadays, though, I still think the American public is too fucking stupid to have the responsibility to choose who the president is. Oh, fuck yeah, dude.
Look at all these stories we're reading, shit but, like
but
that.
But here's
Holy
the thing.
Fuck,
we,
man.
We all have the ability to go out and look and see what the issues are, but instead, we listen to political ads and shit that we see on CNN and Fox News.
Yep.
Because we're all fucking too dumb to go out and look for it ourselves.
And that's the thing I can't stand, especially, like, for all you Bernie Sanders lovers out there, you know, I fucking hate you. Because I have never seen a praise for such a person in my fucking life. It was like these people were gonna die if, you know, they didn't see Bernie Sanders become president. And
Bernie had some good ideas.
I know, and I'm not questioning that he wasn't a good person. I have no fucking clue. I don't know much about him. I hate all fucking politicians. Well, but Bernie, they were just, see the people, like, like they were praising
him. Oh, yeah, they
were
ridiculous.
It was like he was a god or something, and I'm like, you guys are fucking
Well, that's what people
pathetic.
Are doing with Trump now.
I know, and it's all the politicians. I'm just using him as an example because it's the worst I've seen.
Yeah, I'm starting to refer to these people as evangelical Trump supporters. They're literally like evangelical Christians out there. They believe everything they hear.
I know, they're going to start making gold statues of these fucking people or something. And but here's the thing.
And I'll tell you what, though. Anybody who's probably out there voting for Hillary, chances are every single one of them all knows she's a crooked politician.
Yeah, they just feel like this is my word or this is my say or something.
Well, they're just going for her platform.
We need a sound effect.
Yeah, they're just going for her platform over his is all it is. Everybody knows she's a crooked politician. Yeah. Everybody knows it.
Yeah, like I said, it's basically what position do you want to get fucked in.
Yeah.
That's all it is. And
I mean, do you want more of the same, or do you want something completely unpredictable that could go fucking totally off kilter, or maybe not?
Yeah.
I don't know.
And like I said, I think we should do what Ukraine does, just fucking fist fight. Like, the one I saw, this guy was just ranting about stuff. This guy, okay, he was being dramatic, the guy that was talking. Right. Well, this guy had a thing of roses that he brought to the thing, ran up and handed it to him like, okay, we get it, you're full of shit. And they just fucking fist.
That's the most beautiful thing I've ever heard
of. I know,
of.
And I was just like, that, Ukraine, you got it right.
I'll tell you though, back to Bernie Sanders for a minute, though. The dude had some good ideas, but he has no clue how to pay for anything.
I know.
And, you know, that's the problem with socialism. You eventually run out of other people's money.
I know. And it's just socialism doesn't work. we've seen it numerous times. It works for a little bit.
There's nothing wrong with trying to give social services to people to mm-hmm. be able to have better lives. I agree with that shit wholeheartedly. But you can't just sit here and try to give everything away. It doesn't work.
And like I said, I do believe somewhat he probably is a good person. I seen a video of him where someone thanked him in a speech, and off camera he was like crying. So I do believe that maybe he's not.
He had
a bot.
Great ideas.
I know.
Maybe he's not a bot. Has no way how to do it.
And here's another thing. Maybe say he was in office for 8 years. Okay, and those 8 years.
Oh, he was in office for a hell of a lot longer than that.
No, I mean say he was president and he was in office for 8 years. Okay, gotcha. And he would acquire these ideas, which would give the government more power. Okay. My worried would be after that 8 years, someone might get in there that might take advantage of that. That isn't as good-hearted as Bernie Sanders.
Look at the fucking Patriot Act. Obama re-signed that shit. You would think Obama, of all people.
I know.
Mr. Hope and Change would have been the first one to say, okay, well, we're going to relinquish this power.
Yeah, and it's scary.
And he re-signed it.
Because you see the Patriot, or you hear about it and stuff like that, but and you're like, oh, whatever, you know, and you sort of ignore it. But then you go into banks. You go other places and they have just signed.
It's a post 9/11 world.
I know.
We should be increasing our security to some extent. But, you know, all the security theater we have, like the TSA, is all fucking retarded. The TSA has never, never once successfully stopped a terrorist act.
I know. And it's just a fucking pain in the ass.
All they do is confiscate nail clippers.
I know. And, like,
Somebody snuck in with bombs in their shoes, so then they start checking for bombs in their shoes. Everything they started doing has been after the fact.
Yeah, exactly.
It's just security theater to make idiots feel better about shit.
Yeah, it makes you feel safe.
Make them feel that the government's doing something. It's just like with all the gun control shit.
Mm.
I can't generalize here because I don't have facts in front of me, but most of the school shootings and things I've heard, most of the gun attacks I've heard, that haven't been acquired through legal means, or they were completely acquired through legal means, and the guy just ended up turning out to be fucking crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? These extra things that they do for gun control is never going to fix the problem.
Yeah, because they said, you know, well, we're going to do stuff. We're going to do stricter background checks. The last 8 mass shootings, I think, or something, I think it's even more than that, to be honest, were bought with background checks. So obviously background checks really don't do shit. When a person snaps, they're going to snap, you know what I mean?
And I believe there should be common sense regulations on guns just because, like, you know, you have to have a license to drive a car. You should probably have something to shoot a fucking gun.
Yeah.
I don't have a problem with that. I don't have a problem with common sense shit. But on the other hand, some of the backhanded shit they're doing, like increasing the cost of ammunition,
mm-hmm.
which is basically a backhanded form of gun control, out of line.
Yeah. Exactly.
You know, and all these things that they're doing like that, that's the problem. And the problem is every time somebody gets shot or something's going on, we get this knee-jerk reaction.
People are irrational. They just get irrational.
They have a knee-jerk reaction to say, save me, make me feel safer, make me feel secure.
Yeah.
Wrap me in this blanket of bullshit so that I can go home and sleep at night.
That is never going to solve any problems. That's why it's my opinion that you should always try to take care of yourself and defend yourself.
Right.
And when I say defend yourself, I don't mean with a gun or whatever, but I mean, you know, you should know how to chop wood. You should know, you know, how to do basic stuff to where when stuff happens. Like, my fucking heat's out right now. Like, I want to chop some motherfucking trees down.
I have a wood stove at home. I bet you wish you were me.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
I give a fuck if my heat goes out.
Like, last night, I have this little, like, Eden Pure or whatever the fuck it's called, and it was still, you know, pretty cold fucking last night. I'm like, I'm going to Paul Bunyan some fucking trees outside right now. Because, like, you know, I think everyone should know how. I just really
speaking of which, I got a little story to tell you. A long time ago, I lived in a trailer park. You remember that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I lived in a trailer park because, of course, I fucking did. Yeehaw! Watch some NASCAR and drink some Miller Lite. Anyway, I lived in a trailer park and I had to like drive through somebody else's driveway to get to my house. And these guys had no heat, so what they did is they would take the metal box of a furnace and carry it out. And if you've ever seen a trailer furnace, they're like built into the walls. They're like a big metal box attached to the vent to go outside. Well, they would take this box outside, have a fire going, they'd take a big ass log that they got going on fire and they put it inside for coals in the furnace and carry it back inside. And then when it got cold, they would go and do it again.
Hey man, you gotta do what you gotta do. Like,
they also had a toilet on their front lawn.
And that's the funny thing, like it was last year, I went to a BlizzCon thing in California. And California people are completely different than Pennsylvania people.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if the electricity went out over there, they would be fucked. Everything is technology. Everything is, if something's not telling me what to do, I don't do it. Like, I'm standing there, and, you know, the light's red, the cars are all stopped, and the light's sent there for the walk sign for people to walk. And I'm like, what the fuck are people waiting for? Can't you look both ways? Just no common sense. It is very scary out there. And it's like, hey, you want to get something to eat? First thing, they look right on the phone. What's the closest place? I'm like, I can see the Denny's right out the window. Like, it's just, it's very, and it is an extreme. That actually happened.
Those motherfuckers!
They're like,
I haven't played a sound effect in a while.
I know we're getting a little serious here. But we were talking about Denny's. Let's go to Denny's. And I could literally see it right out the window down the street. And people are looking on their phones to where it's at. And it's just a different world. And it's very...
I'm pretty reliant on technology myself.
I know. And I am too. When the internet goes out, I'm like, oh, man. It's horrible.
I'll tell you what, though. The biggest thing for me, I have no sense of direction. None. Having a cell phone with GPS has been a godsend.
Oh, yeah,
for me.
Of course. Either know that one time we went to a... who was that in Philly that we seen? Bible Basher.
Oh, yeah. We saw Deicide in Philly with our buddy Matt.
And we took some...
Hi, Matt. I know you're out there watching.
Where's my muffin, Matt?
He's one of our loyal viewers. Hi, Matt. How you doing? We went to see Deicide in Philly, yeah.
Yeah, and this GPS took us. We were like...
We were
like,
in the middle of fucking...
We were, like, grabbing stuff.
Fucking
like,
deliverance country.
Like, if some KKK member comes at us, I'm swinging. But it got us there. I don't know how it did.
We drove through a pile of manure, but we got there.
We were going through this road, and this pile of manure was on the road so much we had to go over
out. Yeah, somebody delivered manure, and it just spilled all out into the road.
Yeah. And that actually reminds me, I had one time a band staying with us, and they were from New York City.
Mm-hmm.
And just how places are different, how we're talking about that. They got in trouble because they parked outside of our house. Well, in New York City, when you're trash, you take it out and you put it on your sidewalk.
Right, yeah.
There was five of them, and they had trash in their van. So they think, hey, that's what you do everywhere. So in Pennsylvania, they take their trash, they walk out, and they put it next to the street. Well, a cop sees it and pulls them over and flips balls on them. And is like, what are you guys doing? Where are you at? Do you have any drugs? Like, goes full, like... FBI SWAT team. And they're like, I'm sorry, that's what you do in New York City. You just put trash out in the fucking sidewalk.
It's, you know, it's culture shock.
Yeah, I felt bad for them. I was like, oh my God, these fuckers are going to because they smoked a lot of pot. Like, I don't know how they didn't get caught because I was like, oh my God, they're going to jail. They're fucking how many miles from home? They hid it from them somehow. That's how I know they were professionals. Yeah. That reminds me of that one video where this van gets pulled over and he has a fuckload of marijuana. So he ties it to a bunch of balloons and just lets it out of the window. And the cops are trying to shoot it down with a gun. And I was like, that fucking pothead is a genius.
Pot geniuses. Yeah. They can fucking turn anything into a bong.
Can't do anything else, but they can fucking MacGyver anything.
You know, back in high school, metal shop, people are... Oh, excuse me, people are making these fucking bongs and shit. Yeah. And the teacher had no idea. He was like 85.
Yeah. I was like making mini guillotines for the, you know, hamsters. And, no, I'm just joking. Oh my God. Am I? Speaking of rednecks and stuff like that, I guess you have a funny story about NASCAR, believe it or not.
Oh, this is a good one. A car strikes 22 pedestrians in the parking lot after a NASCAR race in Martinsville.
Oh, man.
Apparently on Sunday, Martinsville, they had a race. I don't know. I don't fucking watch NASCAR because there's a bunch of people turning left. I don't give a fuck. Anyway, so this NASCAR fan who presumably was drunk, I would have to imagine.
No way.
he's driving an SSR convertible. In a handicapped parking area.
Oh, it's even in a handicap.
From a handicapped parking area. You can't make this shit up.
See, I thought all people at NASCAR races were handicapped.
Well, he attempted to pass a Jeep while waiting in post-race traffic and struck a crowd of pedestrians. 22 fucking people.
Oh, and did it say, did they die or he just hit 22?
No,
people?
Nobody died.
Oh, okay, thank God. But he's thank God he was drunk.
He's just fucking flooring 22 people. God damn it, Bernice, you hold my beer. I gotta get out of the Martinsville Speedway. Boom, 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 boom.
He was like, God, they put a lot more speed bumps in here last time I was here. And I like it how it's a convertible, so he probably just had bodies flinging at him.
I told you gotta get in or get out of the way.
And he's so wasted, the bodies are probably hitting him in the face, and he thinks it's just his wife beating him like she usually does because he, you know, didn't take the trash out or something. Oh, man.
Bernice, you get me that Budweiser out of the cooler in the back.
Oh, man. That's so great.
And he's going to go home to the trailer park. and with his toilet in the front yard, heating his house with logs and shit, and he's gonna be on Cops.
Oh man,
Bernie says, "Told you to get back in the house."
What's that say right there? What's it say, Wolf?
Wolf, he was Roger Wolf. He was one of the witnesses.
Oh, okay.
He said the driver said to be Ed.
Our governor's name Wolf, so I thought maybe he got into it somehow. I was like, what?
It's in Martinsville, Virginia.
Okay, that's right.
Tom Wolf ain't in Martinsville, Virginia.
I know, but I just saw Wolf, and I'm like, who in the fuck is it? I know. Oh, man, that's funny.
Well, I'll be damned. It says alcohol does not appear to have been a factor in the crash.
Bullshit.
Wow.
Dude, everything has to deal with alcohol. I remember my one friend, he was telling me about, he went to a race in South Carolina, and they literally had a four-wheeler with a trailer attached to the back of it, and they were just driving around the whole thing having an orgy on the back. They were funneling beers, just, hey, who wants to get on? And I can't imagine why. AIDS and
Hell,
diseases
like
get
you.
Spread.
You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
You got Jimmy Ray fucking Bobby Sue.
Hey, why the hell not, man?
Oh, man. So no one died, though.
Those people know how to party. Yeah, no one died.
Oh, man. That's hilarious. Oh, jeez.
Oh, yeah. Nothing like driving around in circles to make you a little crazy.
Oh, man. That's funny, though. But whatever. You know, he was probably wasted. He's, like, getting all excited about the motors and the engines. He's just like, you know what? I want to be a NASCAR driver. Dream.
All right, so here's one for you. I got a good one. So what do you do if you have the last name Hussein and you want to return an iPhone?
You become president.
No, what you do is you have to prove that you're not a dead Iraqi dictator. So here's a good one.
Oh, man.
Apple refused to refund a man whose name was... I apologize for this because I'm going to butcher the hell out of this poor man's name. Sharakat Hussein.
Sharakat? That sounds like a wine. Right. 1987 Sharakat.
Well, he's a 26-year-old man. Mm-hmm. United States, I believe. Yeah, he's from the United States. He's a 26-year-old man. And he went to return his iPhone to the Apple store for whatever reason and got an email.
He bought it for that bitch. He's like, I found out what she's going to do with it.
Anyway. so he tried to return his iPhone. I guess he didn't go to an iPhone and an Apple store. He sent it back.
Wow, okay.
And he got an email that they refused to return the money to him until he proved he was not Saddam Hussein.
Oh my god!
Because they apparently they apparently have a denied parties list, and Saddam Hussein is on the denied parties list.
Even
so it is against
dead.
Government regulations.
Even though he's dead.
Yeah, he's dead. he wasn't able to receive his money because he wasn't able to prove to Apple that he was...
Oh, my God.
Not Saddam Hussein.
People are so...
Who was hanged in 2006.
Fucking stupid, man. And this is the thing. Technology is good, but this is the whole thing. Because I guarantee... You know, they're in the grind of the daily work. You know, they have paperwork, and they're like, oh, Saddam Hussein, oh, we can't refund that terrorist. They probably didn't even realize it. People just, like, and that's the thing. I was telling you the other day, I go to, like, AutoZone or something for a part or something, and the first thing they have no knowledge of anything there. They get on their computer, and they look up, and the computer mm-hmm. tells them what to do. If the computer's down, you're fucked. Like, they don't know what to do, and this... I don't know if it's what happened, but this seems like one of the things where you just type a name in a computer, the computer tells you, and that's the thing. Did the computer, like, tell them it was a terror?
I have no idea.
Or was this someone just overreacting?
I have no idea.
Oh,
actually,
man.
This happened in the UK, I guess.
Oh, okay.
Thought it was US, but either way.
I told you I fucking hate Apple. that's embarrassing. If I was that person that said that, I would be fucking embarrassed. That I'm not, because who doesn't know that he was killed? It was like how long ago?
Yeah, 2006.
Oh yeah.
So it was 10 years ago. It's not like it's recent news.
But that's the thing. That doesn't really surprise me. They did a thing on a college campus where they interviewed people about just simple U.S. history.
Right.
And they asked questions like, who won the U.S. Civil War? People said the British. No, dude, it's so bad. People, I know, you can only facepalm that. And this is college. Like, this is, these people have lived on Earth for, you know, a good 18, 19, 20 years. And it's just like, what? I was like, dude, this is this real life? People said British. One of them said the Nazis. And the most priceless thing was, is when you watch this video, the seriousness on their face when they say the answer, like they think they're right.
Yet we're allowed to elect the president.
I know. That's what I'm saying. And our friend Jason, we're going to have him on the show sometime. When we talk about this stuff, he basically said that. He's like, hey, the Electoral College is basically, hey, you're too stupid to, or, you know, to pick a president. And I'm like, yeah, you're sort of fucking right.
All right. So, yeah. On to the next thing.
Which is, it's a, oh, man.
I got another good one for you here.
Oh, great.
So, here's a scenario for you. You're a British Airlines pilot, and you have nothing better to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, long transatlantic flight. What should you do?
Masturbate.
Apparently some guy here agrees with you. But
get rid of that cancer.
Captain Colin Glover, allegedly. gotta put that in there. Allegedly. Took pictures of himself in stockings. masturbating while flying the fucking plane.
I'm sorry, people that are just listening, I'm looking at some of these pictures. I'll try to post them on YouTube later. But they're so ridiculous. Like, he's literally wearing stockings. And he's like, in the one picture, he's flying the plane with his feet in stockings. And he's that's why I like the word allegedly, because right here you can see that he's doing it.
He's claiming it's not him.
You're like, that ain't my feet.
Feet, dog.
He actually, oh, man, he has porn magazines laid out and everything. Oh, yeah. Jesus. He's probably, he's smart, because he's probably like, as long as I don't get my face in, if I get caught, I can say it's not me.
Too bad he doesn't have, like, an identifying mole on his foot or something.
He's like, I'm throwing the black box out, because they ain't going to like what they find on this.
Yeah, you know, and there's shots of him here displayed full on cock and balls out while he's got the stockings on.
Oh, man.
It's pretty bad.
I guess autopilot just takes over everything. You're like, man, I went to school for this shit. This autopilot makes this job boring. I guess, I don't know.
Don't they have cameras and shit in there? Well, obviously.
Yeah, they probably do. And that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know. And he doesn't have a co-pilot or anything?
I guess not.
Because if I was a co-pilot, I'd be like, Frank, what are you doing, man? I'd be like, calm down.
They even had an expert in here to sit here and testify that it wasn't a simulator. So according to the expert, that's a real plane cabin.
Oh, because did the guy use an excuse it was a simulator?
No, they're saying, as definitive proof, somebody did this in the cockpit.
That was pretty good.
he goes, you can, if you're flying, you can fly into serious turbulence. This person is in danger of losing his aircraft and his job and his junk, apparently. Yeah. He said it was unlikely the pictures were taken on a simulator. You can tell by the lighting it was in a plane. There's also more going on in the control panels than on a simulator. It looks like a live aircraft.
Oh, my God. And I'm just thinking, I've flown a lot. I've flown a lot in my life, and I'm just thinking, like, how many pilots have done this while I'm on the
I've never got on an airplane, and I'm not thinking I'm about to
really?
Start
You've never
soon.
Flew?
Nope.
Oh, man, I never knew that about you. You got to, man.
I'm terrified.
Really?
It's not so much the flying I'm afraid of, it's the falling.
Yeah, that's true.
I tell you what, though, if I was in a situation where that happened, I'd be, like, flapping my arms.
You're like, I'm fucking trying. I'm trying. Actually, if that happened...
Where's it happen? If I died, at least I'll go down knowing that I gave him my best
I would look
shot.
At the closest woman and be like, yo, let's have sex. I'd be like, dude, we're going to die, probably. Do you want to have some sex? And if she says no, I'll go to the stewardess. I'll ask whoever it was. If we run out of women... You know, I'll just jump out naked in stockings.
Yeah, why the fuck not?
Oh, man, that's fucking hilarious. I can't believe you never flew, man. You got to, man. It is so much fun. I love it.
Nah, that's all right.
Oh, I love it. It is so much fun.
All right. Well, I think we better wrap it up. We're at an hour.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, I just want to take a second to tell you all about Patreon. If you like what we do and you want to help us keep doing it, go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. You can go and get yourself some fantastic prizes and goodies if you get in there and sign up. And, you know, for $20, you can get yourself a T-shirt if you pledge $20 an episode. Hell, for $100 an episode, you can be on the show.
Yeah, buddy.
So go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. And if you're watching on YouTube, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. That helps us out big time. Mm-hmm. If you subscribe, make sure you hit the little bell so you get notified every time we upload. If you're listening on iTunes, feel free to give us a review or a comment. We appreciate it. It helps us out a lot.
Yes.
So, all right, everybody. Thanks a lot. This has been Openly Hostile Opinions, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
In case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.